So you've got a new Mac and you're ready to move the data from your current computer to your new one. What's good everyone, I'm Dave, and in this video we'll go through step by step how to use Migration Assistant to move all your user accounts, settings, applications, and documents from one Mac to another. Migration Assistant is a built-in Mac application that's probably the most convenient way to transfer data between your Macs versus manually recreating your user accounts, account settings, manually installing applications, and moving documents over. Migration Assistant is available on older Macs running macOS Lion OS X 10.7 or later. During the initial setup of your Mac, you do have the option to run Migration Assistant. However, if you're not ready, you can skip that step and come back to it at a later time, which we're doing in this video. A few things before we get started. Just like moving from one house to another, you'd usually go through and get rid of old items so you don't have to move more than you need to. The same can be applied to your old computer by going through Finder and deleting any old files and unused applications, as well as reorganizing files and folders. You can also use applications like Clean My Mac to do a scan of your computer, not sponsored.
In this example, I'm using the free version of Clean My Mac, and it's found about 14 gigs of files that could potentially be deleted. I'll see what file makes up these 14 gigs and if there's anything that can be deleted or archived to an external hard drive.
Next, most importantly, you'll want to make sure that both Macs are running the latest version of macOS available for your model, especially the Mac that you're migrating your data to. At time of recording in March 2022, I'll be migrating data from my late 2013 MacBook Pro 15 running macOS Big Sur to my 2021 MacBook Pro 16 running macOS Monterey. Now that both computers are running the latest version of macOS available to them, make sure they're on the same Wi-Fi network, that they're placed close by to each other, and that they're plugged in. Depending on the amount of data being transferred over and the Wi-Fi connection, the whole process can take a few hours, and you don't want either computer to run out of power during the migration. And lastly, before we get started, using Migration Assistant doesn't erase any data from your old Mac.
On the Mac you're moving data from, you'll want to check that your computer has a name. Yes, your Mac does have a name. Open System Preferences, click on Sharing, and at the top next to Computer Name is the name of your Mac. If you'd like to learn more about your Mac's name and how to change it, check out my video linked at the end of this one or linked in the description below. If the computer field name is blank, which it probably shouldn't be, click into the field, enter name, then click outside of it to save the changes. If you're running antivirus and firewall software on either of your Macs, you'll need to turn those applications off on both computers as it'll interfere with the transfer. Once the migration is complete, you can turn the applications back on again. On both Macs, launch Migration Assistant. In Finder, you can get to it from the menu bar by selecting Go and then Utilities. In Utilities, scroll down to Migration Assistant and click on it. Another way is to use Spotlight by hitting Command Spacebar, and in the search bar, start typing the words Migration Assistant. In the search results, click on Migration Assistant. On the Mac that will be receiving the data, click Continue, and when prompted, enter the admin user account password. From the list of options, select From Another Mac, Time Machine Backup, or Startup. Migration Assistant can also work if you're moving from a Windows OS PC. However, only your data will transfer over. On the Mac that the data is coming from, click Continue, and when prompted, also enter the admin user account password here. Then, from the list of options, select To Another Mac. On both computers, click Continue. On the new Mac, you'll see the computer name you'll be moving your data from. Select it from the list, and then hit Continue. A security code will display on both devices. Make sure the code matches, as this will ensure the right devices have been selected. On the old Mac, click Continue. It'll take a few minutes for the data to gather on the old Mac. Once the data on the old Mac has been gathered, a dialog box will appear on the new Mac listing everything that'll be moved over. In it, you can check the data you don't want to bring over. Anything with the right chevron, you can drill down and make more specific choices if needed. I have a second user account on my old Mac that I won't migrate over, so I'll uncheck that. Everything else I'll bring over, so I'll click Continue. Next, you'll be prompted to enter a password to access the user account on the new Mac once migrated over. You can use the same password that you used on the old computer or enter something new. Once that's complete, you'll see a check mark next to the user account. You can now click Continue to move on. Now, the account I'm moving over from the old Mac is an administrator level account, and over on the new Mac, I already have one admin level account. You can have more than one admin account, and this prompt is asking if I want to replace the admin account on the new Mac with the admin account from the old Mac or keep both. I'm going to select keep both. Since a new user account is being added to the new Mac, Migration Assistant needs authorization from the existing admin level account to add this new account. Enter the password. If you're running Migration Assistant during setup, you most likely won't see this. After authorizing the addition of the new user account, you'll get a checkmark. You can click on Continue. Now the migration of data can get started. Now, depending on how much data is being moved over, the whole process could take a few minutes to a few hours, so it's best to leave both computers alone while running Migration Assistant. I had about 240 gigs of data on my old Mac to transfer over, and that included one user account, multiple applications, settings, files, and it took about 45 minutes. When it's done, both Macs will display Migration Completed. The new Mac will restart to finish up the process, and you'll get a second Migration Completed prompt. Click Done. The computer will restart and the login window will display. You can sign in and start accessing the data and applications that were transferred over. After you log into the newly migrated account, you may be prompted with setting up some more account settings, like accessibility, signing in or creating your Apple ID, whether or not you'd like to share your analytics with Apple, I usually don't, and setting up Touch ID if you have that on your Mac. On the old Mac, click on Done in Migration Assistant. You can log into your old Mac, and since the data has not been erased, you can access it as needed. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed it, please give it a like, please consider sharing it, and subscribe to catch more of my videos on using your Mac and about Apple. We'll catch you in the next one. Peace and love.